Although the trap and emulate model seems like it will solve all problems and it worked beautifully on the mainframes, when in the 90s the need to reapply virtualization solutions to the prevalent x86 architecture came up, it turned out that there were certain problems with this model. At the time, x86 platforms had just the four rings. There wasn't any support for root or non-root mode. And so the way to virtualize them would be to run the hypervisor in ring 0 and the guest OS in ring 1. However, it turned out that there were exactly 17 instructions that were privileged in that hardware would not allow them to be executed if they're not issued from the most privileged ring 0. However, they did not cause a trap. Issuing them from another protection level from ring 1 or above wouldn't pass control to the hypervisor and instead would just fail silently. For instance, enabling or disabling interrupts requires manipulating of a bit in a privileged flags register, and this can be done via the popf pushf instructions. However, when these instructions are issued from ring 1 in the pre-2005 architecture, they just fail and the instruction pipeline is allowed to continue to the next instruction. The problem with the situation that there is no trap is that since control isn't passed to the hypervisor has no idea that the OS wanted to change the interrupt status. So the hypervisor will not do anything to change these settings, will not emulate the behavior that was required, that was intended with this instruction. At the same time, because the failure of the instruction was silent, the operating system, the guest OS, doesn't know that anything wrong happened. So the OS will continue its execution, assuming that correctly the interrupts were enabled or disabled as intended. So the OS will then go ahead and perform operations that, for instance, if interrupted, can leave it in corrupt or in deadlocked state, which was intended to be avoided by some manipulation of this flags register to disable interrupts. So clearly, this is a major problem and makes this trap and emulate approach not applicable for these architectures.